Okay, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone, good morning. My name is Amadia Balia Hadiza. I'm from English Education Department, class 6A. So in this occasion, I'm going to tell you the concepts that I got from the book called Encyclopedia of Islam. There are three concepts that I got from this book. The first one is Qiblah, and the second one is Quran, and the last one is Ramadan. So the first one is Qiblah. Qiblah is like the Arabic term for the direction to all Muslims face when they are praying. So for example, when you are going to pray, you have to face Qiblah. So Qiblah is like it is toward the Ka'bah that located in Mecca. In most view, the Qiblah is indicated by the mihrab, a concave niche located in the wall that faces Mecca, usually to the left of the pulpit, or it is called mimbar, inside the main prayer of the pulpit. In addition to serving as the orientation for daily prayer, the Qiblah is also the direction toward which the dead are oriented when they are buried, and animals are turned toward it when sacrificed in accordance with Muslim dietary laws. Conversely, observant Muslims avoid facing the Qiblah when they are relieved themselves, and they avoid sleeping or sitting with their feet toward it so as not to insult or insult the holiness of Islam's most sacred place. So to determine the proper direction, you have to know that with some precision, with some precision, both the longitude and latitude one of own location and those of Mecca, the city toward which of one must face. Once that is determined, the values are applied to a spherical triangle and the angle from the local meridian to the required direction of Mecca can be determined. So, it is all about Qiblah. The second one, it is about the Quran. Quran in Arabic is called, it is mean recitation or reading. Quran is the sacred scripture of Islam. Muslim believe it contains the infallible word of God as revealed to our prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the Arabic language during the latter part of his life, between in the 610 and 632 in the Western calendar. They also hold that is the last of a sequence of revealed book delivered to humankind through the history. But because previous scriptures, particularly the Torah and Gospel, had become corrupted, it is the most perfect of all revelation. Through recitation, worship, exegesis, and the art called calligraphy, Muslims have made it part of daily life wherever they are. So it is about Quran. It is all about Quran. We move to the last one. The last one is called Ramadan. We are in the month of Ramadan. So Ramadan also spelled like Ramazan, Ramzan, Ramadan, and Ramadan. So in Indonesia, we call it as Ramadan. So Ramadan is the ninth month of the Islamic calendar, observed by Muslim worldwide as a month of fasting, or we know it as Sawum. It is like prayer, reflection, and community. A commemoration of Muhammad's first revelation, the annual observance of Ramadan is regarded as one of the five pillars of Islam. So the Ramadan is the fourth out of five pillars of Islam. It is last 29 to 30 days from one sighting to the crescent moon to the next. Ramadan is the time of obligatory for us to fasting for all able Muslim in the world, and an important time for commemorating Islamic sacred history. The month-long fast is the four pillar of Islam that require us to abstaining from all food, drink, and sexual activity during the daylight hours. At the end of the day, we can broke the fasting with a light meal called iftar. It is a month that foster us to communal solidarity and individual pity. So mosque attendance like highly increases at this time, and many Muslims fulfill their charitable obligation in addition to ritual fasting, daily prayer, and acts of charity. Observant Sunni Muslims also perform super eregutory prayers known as Tarawih at night throughout the month. So I think that's enough for me. So there are three concepts that so I have told you. The first one is Qiblah, Quran, and Ramadan. I hope it is all clear for us. Thank you for listening and watching this video. Hope you guys have a good day. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.